Hey, what's up guys, I'm Styler, and in this video I'm going to unbox, set up and have a first look at the bezel-less Yumi Digi Crystal, which currently only costs $107 for the small version, link below in the video description. To make one thing clear, this is not a full review will follow later, when I have tested the phone as my daily driver for some time. So the Crystal comes in a typical white and blue Yumi package, that we also have seen with some other Yumi phones in the past. On the front it says Crystal and we see the website and the phone. On the back, funny, we also actually see the back of the phone. This factory Yumi sticker indicates that the phone is brand new and have not been opened. In the top we find all the specifications and the IMEI numbers. So now let me cut the sticker, so we can have a look inside. Let's turn it around. And here we first see the phone. It is placed inside a clear soft cover and it has some protective plastic attached on the display. On the back we see the dual camera, small single LED flash and a fingerprint sensor. Okay, let me put the phone aside. And let's finish the unboxing. First an envelope. Below we find a wall charger and USB Type-C cable. The connector on the USB Type-C cable looks to be in a standard size, not a funny long version or something like that, so that's good. The charger is very small and it looks to be a normal charger with 5V 1A, so this will probably not fast charge the phone. And in this envelope we seem to have a screen protector. First a small metal pin to open the dual SIM tray, wipes, and a standard screen protector, and last an English quick start guide. So now back to the phone. And let me now remove this clear soft case. The case is flexible and soft, but still in a quality so it will protect the phone. Nice looking phone. Let me remove the front plastic and it seems just to be protective plastic. Below it there is no pre-installed screen protector, which is a shame in my opinion. In the bottom we have a microphone, USB Type-C port and a loudspeaker. The display is on 5.5 inch and in full HD. On the left we have the power and volume buttons and these are 100% solid. In the top we find a 3.5mm headphone jack and something that looks like an IR blaster, but I think this is in fact a proximity sensor. On the right we have a dual hybrid SIM tray for 2 nano SIMs or 1 nano plus 1 micro SD card. And like on all these bezel-less phones, the 5MP front camera is placed in the bottom. Let me now remove the plastic protection from the back. And the back is in fact made of glass, so this is not plastic. In the light it looks very nice, but it does attract fingerprints very fast. The dual camera consists of a 13MP plus a secondary 5MP sensor. The thickness of the back and front glass seems to be average, nothing special but okay. The frame is definitely made of thick hard metal and gives a good grip around the phone. Let's now power up the phone. First we see the Yumi Digi logo. Then we see the standard setup. Let me just run through these very quick. And done. At first glance, the launcher seems smooth. It doesn't seem to have any bloatware pre-installed and it has a built-in FM radio. The quick toggles look standard. And the highest brightness seems good, while the lowest isn't that low, even though it looks very dark here in the video. Now let me scroll through the phone settings. Let's check it out and see if there is anything special. In display we have live display. That's a bit different from what I have seen on other budget phones. We have options for a notification LED. The sound settings seems pretty standard. The battery can be shown in percentage. And then we have something called keys. And that's pretty cool, because here you can set up each key individually and also functions for long press and double tap. Even the power button can be set up to turn on the flashlight if you hold it down while the display is off. In accessibility, we also again find Quick Boot, something I haven't seen for a long time on many China phones, while in the old days many phones had this option, so it's nice to see it back again. And last, About Phone, where we find the build number, Android version and support for wireless updates. The on-screen buttons can of course also be hidden. And now a quick look inside the camera app. It has support for different color filters. You press here in the top to enable the bokeh mode. And let's also have a look inside the camera settings. These look like stock media camera settings, so nothing special to see here. The rear camera seems okay for the price. And the front camera is what I would just call average, because there's not much detail. We need to remember that this is a phone for only $107, so for that you can't really complain. So that's it for the full unboxing, setup and first look of the Yumi GG Crystal. A full review will follow later on my channel, so stay tuned for more. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment below. Drop a like if you enjoyed the video and subscribe for more. Thank you for watching this video, and I hope to see you in my next one.